Hi friends, welcome back to Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Today I'll show you how I make Kori Rotti or the Mangalorean Chicken Curry. This is a spicy dish of Udupi-Mangalorean cuisine. A combination of red chilies based chicken curry and crispy dry wafers made from boiled rice. Kori Rotti or the Mangalorean Chicken Curry is a tasteful dish made using chicken, spices and coconut milk. The curry is eaten with chewy and crunchy bread called roti. The roti is generally sourced from the market and is staple in most Mangalorean homes. This is a must curry on the menu whenever we have friends or family coming over for lunch or dinner. This Kori Rotti or the chicken curry is also known as Kori Ghassi. You can serve this curry with roti or even with sannas, appams, pulao or a simple neer dosa. So here's how we make the Kori Rotti. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. If you like this recipe, do give a thumbs up and click the like button. So let's check out the ingredients. Here I have taken 6 cardamom pods, 6 cloves, around 10 to 12 pepper, 4 pods of garlic, a small piece of tamarind, 1.5 teaspoon of coriander seeds, 3-4 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 3 Kashmiri chilies, 6 to 7 bedgi chilies, 2 have to dry roast these ingredients on slow flame. You need not add any oil, just dry roast them. Now add in the pepper. This is around 10 to 12 pepper, 1 inch piece of cinnamon, cumin seeds, coriander seeds. Add everything together and roast it till you get a nice aroma and the color changes to a slight golden brown. At the end, you can add 1 teaspoon of poppy seeds or khashkhash. This is optional, but if it is available, please do add. It brings a nice flavor to the curry. Once done, remove it from the pan. Be careful, the poppy seeds tend to burn very quickly. Add in turmeric powder, that is 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder. Give a nice good mix. Transfer it to a plate. I have taken 1 large onion. I have used the same pan, hence the yellowish color. Add a teaspoon of oil and fry the onions till it is nice and golden. See that you do not burn the onions, otherwise the curry will change its color. Once the onions are nice and soft, remove it and cool it. This is 2 large onions sliced, 1 large tomato chopped fine. Take the cooking pot, add around 2 teaspoons of ghee. You can add vegetable oil also, but I like to add ghee. Add in the sliced onion. Fry till the onion is nice and soft. It takes a few minutes. I add a teaspoon of oil also when I am frying. You can use only oil or only ghee. Once the onions are a little soft, add in salt. It will fasten the process of cooking. Usually at times the onion takes pretty long to soften. Once this is nice and soft, you can add in the chopped tomatoes and fry it well till the tomatoes are nice, soft and mushy. It will take around 3 to 4 minutes. Since we are using broiler chicken, we need to fry this onion and tomato very well, since the chicken doesn't take long to cook. But if you are using the country chicken, the homegrown chicken, it takes a little longer to cook, and hence the onions and tomatoes will also get mushy as the chicken is cooking. This is 1 kg of chicken. This is cut pieces, not the whole bird. Once this is nicely fried and the onions and tomatoes are soft and mushy, you can add in the chicken. Saute the chicken for a few minutes till the chicken changes its color and it's nicely coated with the onion and tomato masala. Say around 2 to 3 minutes of cooking. See that the flame is on slow to medium. Remember, we have added salt already. Once the chicken is sauteed well, you can add water. I used hot water over here so that it cooks fast. Now you have to give it a nice good mix and cook till the chicken is 80 to 85% done. It depends on the variety of chicken. Some tend to cook very fast. I like to add potatoes to my gravy. This is optional. This is the ground masala. Grind it to a nice fine paste. Here the chicken has cooked 85%. Don't cook it more, otherwise the bones tend to separate. At this point of time, add the potatoes, give it a nice good mix, and now let the potatoes and chicken cook till the potatoes are done. I will be adding coconut milk to this gravy. You can check for salt at this point of time. Remember, you have to add the masala, the coconut milk and water also. So accordingly, add your salt. Once the potatoes are done, add in the ground masala and water and give it a nice good mix. This curry is usually on the runnier side. If you want, you can keep it thick also. If you are serving it with rotis, the curry has to be on the runny side. But if you are going to serve it with dosas, appams or pulao, then you can keep it a little thicker as per your preference. Adjust the consistency as you require. I will be adding a little more water as this is served with rotis, and rotis tend to absorb a lot of curry while eating, otherwise they get too dry. Once you have added the required water, adjust the consistency of the gravy. You can cook it till it comes to a nice rolling boil. It will take around 3 to 4 minutes. You can increase the flame once you have added water. Check for salt and add. I felt it was a little less. Once the curry comes to a nice rolling boil, then you can add the coconut milk. This is 1.5 to 1/3 cup of thick coconut milk. You can use the ready-made store-bought coconut milk also. Add it, give it a good mix. If it is on the thicker side, add a little water. And now let it come to a nice boil. Say around 2 to 3 minutes. Once it comes to a boil, switch off the flame and let the curry set for 10 to 15 minutes. And then you are ready to serve it. I hope you like this recipe of mine. Do try it out. And thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And do not forget to click the bell icon to get notified as and when I upload a new recipe. The list of ingredients is given in the description box below. Till we meet again, check out my other recipes at Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Bye, see you soon with a new interesting recipe.